Hi, I'm Peter Vaughan, and what I'm going to be talking about in this particular series, this being series number one, or episode one, you might say, I've got some stuff up on the board here to talk about you specifically. You see, you live in a world with you in it, center, and the entire universe revolves around you. So in every respect, you're the middle of the universe. And whatever's going on out there is your environment, and it affects you because you are in a position of the center of everything. So here you are. I got a little picture of you up here, and you're in the present, almost as if you're watching television through your mind. You're watching the world through your television in the now. You have a memory of what's happened in your past, and in like kind and reflection, you have future thoughts also at the present time about the future for you. So in every respect, you have a past, you have a future, and you are living in the present. And if I said something about maybe a pet that was in your past, like a cat, a dog, a hamster, a mouse, and you might have memories that I've just created in your mind in the present, and you're seeing it on the screen of your mind by the way in which I'm triggering things to do with your brain and its memory. At the same time, I can talk about the future. So right now you might be locked down in this massive world crisis with COVID-19. But at the same time, this recording will be the past by the time you're watching it, because I will have completed it. But you're watching it now. So this video is about time and where you are in it. So as we move through time, what was your memory always remains a memory, always, no matter where you are. This being the future, travel. And you look back, and your future thoughts that you had back here have become memory. And these future thoughts, whether they unfolded or not, was based on your actions and what you knew. And then at this point, you look back at the past, and you now have future thoughts, which will one day become memory. So you are forever living in an envelope of time, which is always gathering and creating memories, thinking about the present, the past, and idealizing or thinking about the future. And you can make that work the way that you want it to work by the way in which you think. So let's just say that where you're going in life, I've got this car rolling along with you in it. Coming back here a fraction, I've got you moving through time. See the little skateboard here? So I've got you on a skateboard, and the skateboard is running on a rough road here. The terrain is rough. So in this respect, for you to move through this particular terrain when it's rough, you would kind of have to flex your legs a little bit and get ready to absorb the shock as you're going through this particular time frame. Now, going back in time, you can remember, and even possibly the present, things could be rough. And so therefore, you're having to flex and try and deflect and absorb all the shocks that are coming to you from your environment. If we move forward here and you wish the future had something a little bit more smooth, not so rough as this, so that you could kind of ease up and enjoy the ride as you're going through on this skateboard. So the terrain here and the terrain here, they're different. And they are different all the time in your life, because every time you wake up, the new day brings new environmental conditions to you. And in this case, COVID-19, which is a coronavirus, which means a flu-type virus, but it is not a flu. It is not an influenza. It is completely different. This series will go into exactly what it is, what it does to you on the inside, and how you can avoid it by knowing where it is ahead of time up here. Because once you know what's ahead, you can make the choice to avoid that and circumnavigate a problem. That's the promise of this video. Now, here you are in your car of life, but at the same time, you, which I'm going to call A, the car I'm going to call B, and your environment I'm going to call C. So here's you in the car. Now, can you think about that? You drive a car one way, and somebody can hop in your car when you got out, and they can drive it, but they'll drive it differently to you. So when you are in your car, you could say that you and your car together are your personality type as you move through life. You can have twins, and they can have the same bodies almost, they're identical, they can wear the same clothes, they're brought up the same way, but they've got different personalities. What's the difference? The difference is the you factor. It has a lot to do with your name. Now I'm going to cover that as we go through this, so just bear with me to kind of get an idea of the flow of how life is and what I have discovered that's going to help you overcome problems in your life. So as you're going through this road in life, you might come across a pothole which is ahead of time for you compared to where you are here. You can be shining the light at night and looking ahead in the day, but there's a pothole here. If you knew that pothole was there, you could slow down, you could avoid it, you could curse the council for not fixing it. You can then drive past it and possibly come up against the railway line, and the bells are flashing. Now, whether they're flashing or not, there's a sign there that says railway. When you come up to this thing, it's kind of good to be cautionary a wee bit about it and not to go barreling across with your headphones in, listening to music, texting or whatever. And guess what? You could discover a train coming along the side and T-boning you. So, caution. Then you've got speed bumps. Now these things are annoying as hell when you're used to zip down a road, but they want you to slow down for all the right reasons, I suppose. But sometimes it's a pain. Slow down, go over the speed bump, because if you hit it at speed, it's going to cause you to bounce and jump and be very uncomfortable, wake you up. Past that, you might find there's a tack on the road. Now a tack may not hurt a car tire, but if it's a spike, broken glass, a piece of metal, then you could hit that. This is all on the journey of your life. And then there are times when you're going to come along the road and come up and find that there's a signpost there that may or may not be there in the form of a signpost, but it's where you have to decide what you're doing and where you're going. And then you've got to choose the reason why. All of these things are going on every day in all of our lives. Not necessarily cars, but the journey of life and its obstacles along the way. What you hope for in the future, what you recall in the past, and how all of this, right up to date, has never been able to be mapped into the future in the form of a model, as they're using today, don't always work. A weather forecast is never always right. And even in companies and businesses where people are having tax accountants or consultants in their firms, production managers, and they do schedules ahead to try and allot what will happen and where the process is going based on the conditions and the ideals of the company at any given time. Do they always work? No. We've got a problem here, but there's hope in it now because there is a law, it's a common law in the universe that says you can't have one thing without its polar opposite. Hence I have two arms and I haven't lost my arm, but it's where you have polar opposites. You can't have, here's a bottle and inside this bottle is space, but you can't have an inside without there being an outside. You can't have a top without a bottom. You can't have a front without a back or a left without a right. So in every respect, everything has a polar opposite. Hot, cold, me, you, night, day, that kind of thing. So what's the polar opposite of the past? Well, the future. What's the polar opposite of hindsight? Foresight. So in other words, if hindsight exists, and the present exists, which is that tipping point, then surely the future must also exist, because at some stage you're going to go into the future and you'll have the past, which is now hindsight. Wouldn't it be cool if we could map that? Wouldn't it be cool if we could not only map it, but we could prove it? Well, I'm here to show you that it can be done. Because for 40 years, now 40 years is a lifetime, it's more than a lifetime for some people, and it's not so much of a lifetime for a person who might be 100. But in my life today, 40 years of working in this field, I have made some discoveries that have proven to be very, very accurate. And it's only because of what I'm going to show you shortly in the next clip. In the meantime, a time slide rule means that you're going from place to place, and like a diarized version of your life, you can look back and make records and look back and flip backwards and forwards, and like a book. You might pick up a book, a storybook, which I don't have with me, and you can open up the front cover and you start reading it. You could flip right to the back, skip all the middle, and read the back end of the book. And you'd know what was coming because it's written. But you didn't know from the front until you had a sneak preview. The point being, it already exists in the book. And the idea is you go through that timeline to get all the excitement. It's the journey. At the end of the journey is when we take account of all of our history. It's all in one package, all inside here. And whatever happens after this life, whatever it is what it is. So let's have a look to see if we can map your future. Or should I say, show you there is a map for your future. Because A, B, and C, as I have up here, you A, your car B, and your car is your body. You live in your body, which is inside the car here. The car is your body, and the environment around you is the area that you're living in. So, A, B, C, I'm going to call you your name story, and C, I'm going to go straight to C, because A and C equal B in this case. C is your environment, and when you mix you and your environment together, you're blending things, you're making a mix. And this mix down the middle here can be slotted as a time frame. Where you are today, where you were yesterday, where you'll be tomorrow. And tomorrow, this is where you are today, that's yesterday, and that'll be tomorrow. Now, if we could do this in your life, is it possible that we could avoid COVID-19? Yeah. Why am I saying that? Because I've shown people how to avoid things in the past, identify things before they happen, and prior to me doing this particular film clip, a week or two more back, three weeks ago, I'm not sure how long it was, it might have even been a month ago, I had some people who were asking me about going to America, and I'm looking at their graphics or their timelines, and I'm going, no, you're not, no. And they said, but why not? And they gave me all the reasons. And I then gave them all the reasons why they shouldn't go. I saw danger, I saw death, I saw financial mess, I saw all sorts of stuff. And when I put it back to them, they made the decision not to go. Guess what they're thinking now? Now, these are real people, people I've known for quite some time who used me as a consultant. If they'd gone to America, they would be locked down now and experiencing stuff that they don't want to experience, and they're glad that they made that decision. Your turn, and what we're going to do next is show you the next level of how we create the timeline. And this is what I do. This is what I do, and you can get me at silverfox@111webnet.com. Silver fox because I was once quite dark brown, and it's gone silvery over the years. And many people might pay for this, but it comes with my hereditary. So, silverfox@111webnet.com, and if you want me, I'm going to be doing some deals for people throughout this period to help you look at your life, where you're going, and what we can do to help you through it, and even give you some insight into the future. Take care, and look forward to the next episode.